So let's get started. How many of you know about the Maslow's hierarchy of needs? We all have studied Maslow's hierarchy of needs, right? So in the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, we said that a person goes through 5 level of needs. Each and every person has 5 different sets of needs, which starts with physiological need. Once your physiological need, like need for wood, food, water, shelter is met, then a person's next set of needs get arisen, which is safety need, need for job security. And then the third level of need, which was called love and belongingness need. You want to be accepted by people, by community. And then the next level of need was the need for self-esteem. And finally, the need for self-actualization. In the same terms, Philip Kotler, the father of marketing management, has also given 5 different needs which are met through a product which is being purchased by a consumer. He said in the year 1960 that any product, talk of whether tangible product or intangible product, it goes through 5 different levels. Now, these 5 different levels would be the benefits or the values which get added to a product which satisfies a consumer at each and every level of this product. So he developed a model which was called 5 product level model. Now, in this model, what he has said that there are 5 levels which each and every product goes through during its lifetime. Now, the first level of this product is called as core benefit or core level of the product, as you can see in this picture. The second level of the product is called as generic level of the product. Now, this can be also called as generic benefits that we get out of a product. The third level of the product is known as expected level of the product. And then comes the fourth level of the product, which is called as augmented level of the product. And finally, you have the fifth level, which is called the potential level of the product. So each of these levels shows different needs which will be fulfilled by a product for the customer. Now, all these 5 levels are also known as value hierarchy. Now, why do we call it value hierarchy? It is because, as I told you earlier, at each of the level, more customer value is added into the product. So as a marketer, when you are designing a product, you have to first of all think that what core benefit is my product going to provide to the customer. Now, if I say you are going to design a product like a soap, now, as a marketer, first of all, you have to think that there are so many brands of soaps which are available in the market. So how are you going to distinguish this product of yours from that of competitor? Why are people going to buy your product? How will you make it different? Right? So the differentiation which will be put into your product, the way you will be making your product unique, the values which will be added to your product will be added at each of these different levels of the product which have been defined by Kotler. So let us see what is this core level of the product. So as I said, the very first level of the product is called core level of the product. In other words, you may also understand it as the core benefit that your product is going to provide to the customer. Now, when I say I purchase a car, why do I purchase a car? Because it is going to give me the benefit of mobility, comfort, safety for my family. If I talk about smartphone, which is again a product, why do I purchase a smartphone? For communication, for connecting with the world, for convenience. 24/7, I can speak to my folks, right? In the same way, if I talk about renting a room in the hotel, why do I rent a room in the hotel? What is the basic purpose behind renting a room in the hotel? What benefit will I get out of it? It is going to give me rest and food. I can sleep in the room, I can take rest in the room, I can get food in the room. So that is the basic purpose or the benefit that a product is going to provide to the customer. Now, as I said earlier, each and every product has similar benefit. If I talk about hotel rooms, whether you talk about a 3-star hotel, whether you talk about a 4-star, 5-star, 7-star hotel, the purpose behind renting a room in a hotel is same, the basic purpose. That is to take rest and to have food. All right. In the same way, whether I purchase an iPhone, whether I purchase a Redmi phone, the basic purpose behind a phone is, a smartphone is convenience, communication, connecting with the world. So that is the core benefit or the core level of the product, which satisfies a particular need, that is the functional need of the product. Now, second level of the product is called generic level of the product or the generic benefits that you will be getting out of a product. Now, if I take the same example of a hotel, what is the generic benefit that you are getting? Generic benefit refers to the qualities of the product. What all features of the product you will be getting? In case of a hotel room, you will be getting a bed, you will be getting, say, some towels, you will be getting, say, a television, Wi-Fi facility. Okay, so all this refers to your generic benefits or the generic level of the product, which provides you with the benefits above the functionality level. So once the generic benefits of the product have been kept in mind by the marketer, the third level is expected level of the product. Now, what is expected level of the product? As a buyer or as a guest who is going to rent a room in the hotel, what do I expect out of the room? If it's a 5-star hotel, then what do I expect? The quality of the room should be really good. By quality, what do I mean? There should be a television set with multilingual channels. There should be a refrigerator so that I can have cold water. The towels should be clean. The bed sheets should be clean. I should have a smart key entry system. What is smart key entry system? Does anybody know what is smart key entry system?
Ma'am, it is a card key which it is used as a master key. You can open the door and you can apply to get power supply at the room at hotels, ma'am, like 7-star hotels.
Okay, smart key entry system is basically your smartphone turns into the key through which you can check in and check out of your room at any time. So you don't need a specific key to open the rooms in the hotel. Marriott Hotel was the first one to introduce this concept whereby your smartphone turns into a key. So all these are expected benefits of the product when we are purchasing or when we are renting a room in the hotel. This is something I expect because I have rented a room in a 5-star hotel. So I expect that all these benefits should be given to me, which you as a marketer should also understand what is being expected by the consumer out of the product which you are offering to them in the market. Now, after having decided on the expected level of the product, comes the next level of the product. That is called augmented level of the product. Now, what do you mean by augmented level of the product? Now, this is something beyond the expectation of the consumer. Now, you have gone to the hotel, right? Now, what did you expect? Clean towels should be there. Wi-Fi 24/7 should be there. But then after getting the room, what do you find is something beyond your expectation? So it is like exceeding the satisfaction of the customer. That is what is being provided to the customer. Example, if I talk about car. You are purchasing a car hoping that it will have normal seat. But what do you get is seats with warmers installed so that you can remain warm throughout while you are in the car. Now, that is something which you did not expect out of the car, but this was being provided to you. So this is called augmented benefits, which you get, which was beyond your expectation and which leads to exceeding your satisfaction. In the same way, if I talk about BMW, if I talk about cars like Audi, Mercedes, what do they give you? They give you satisfaction beyond your imagination. They give you luxury on four wheels. And that is what is the best example of augmented level of the product or the augmented benefits. In the same way, if I take some another example, for example, you are purchasing a laptop and your retailer is giving you your laptop bundled with MS Office package with 5-year warranty for no cost. Now, what is this? This is augmented benefit that you are receiving along with your laptop. This was not something which you expected. You just purchased a laptop, but you were not aware that what you will be getting will be also a free version of MS Office for the next 5 years with free warranty at no cost. Now, this is called as augmented benefits, which are designed into a product. Then the last level is called potential product. Now, potential benefits or potential level of the product means what transformations can your product undergo in the future? I am not sure how many of you are aware that Mark Zuckerberg, CEO of Facebook, has proposed an idea whereby the televisions will be replaced by virtual glasses. So what he has proposed, and he's coming up with an idea that in the next 5 to 10 years, there will be no television sets. The family members in the house will be sitting with virtual glasses. And even if you're outside the house, all you have to, if you want to watch any movie channel, you want to watch music channel, you want to watch business news, all you have to put in is your visual glasses. Okay, these visual glasses are nothing but virtual glasses. And of course, you will have to pay a subscription fee. As you get a cable service or a Tata Sky service, what do? You pay a subscription fee, and then whatever channels for which you have paid the subscription fee, you can watch and enjoy the TV. In the same way, with the virtual glasses also, you will have to pay a subscription fee, and then accordingly, for the channels for which you have paid the fees, you can watch those channels using your virtual glasses. So if all the family members are sitting together, they do not have to fight that I want to watch, say mother says, I want to watch a cookery show. Son says, I want to watch music channel. Father says, I want to watch a Discovery channel. Okay. And somebody else says, sister says, I want to watch a business news. And there's only one or two television sets. And so there's a fight among the family members. But with virtual glasses, you are sitting quietly in the room, and all the different family members can watch the channels of their choice. Now, that is what is meant by potential benefit of the product, how your products will be transforming in the future. In the same way, you know, this potential benefit of the product, as a marketer, you have to be very careful about this final level of the product, because this is what could make your product or it can break your product. If you remember, in the beginning, we used to have telephone sets in the home. And for pretty long time, we used to use these telephones. And slowly and steadily, these were replaced by pagers. But then pagers lived very short. And soon after pagers, we had mobile phones, which again lasted for a couple of years. But then these mobile phones were replaced by smartphones, right? What I'm trying to say is that all these are transformations which have led into telecommunication, right? Starting with telephone, and then how did it keep modifying, transforming until you got what was called smartphones, okay? So when as a marketer, you're designing your product, you also have to think about how can you modify and update your product in the long run? What would be the updated version of your product in the long run? So your potential level of the product, you have to keep an eye on it all the time, because it can bring your business down to the street or it can turn you into a millionaire. Moving ahead. Now, let us move to the example which I was quoting to make you people better understand the core level of the product and the other different levels of the product. Now, the first level of the product I said was core level or the core benefit or the purpose for which a product is being purchased. Here, I have taken the example of a hotel room which you are renting. First level of the product is giving you is rest and sleep. Moving to the second level of the product, or the second benefit that you get out of the product, is generic level of the product. In this, what are you getting? The hotel room. What type of room are you taking? The bed. What type of bed? Bathroom. What type of bathroom? towels, Wi-Fi, okay, the general facilities or the features of a product which you are getting with the product that you have taken on rent. Then comes the third level of the product, that is expected level of the product, whereby you expect clean bed, fresh towels, 24/7 coffee shop, swimming pool, spa, and as I told you, smartphone key entry system. Now let us see augmented level of the product. Now this is something very interesting. Why it is interesting is because, just try to understand what I am saying. In some 5 to 10 years back, the smartphone key entry system was considered as an augmented benefit. But when over the years, many of the hotels, 5-star and 7-star hotels, started providing this service to their customers, it was turned into expected level of the product. So you need to remember that whenever you are designing augmented benefit for the customer, after a period of time, the consumers start taking them as expected benefits. They expect that this should be provided. So augmented level of the product soon may become expected level of the product. And then you have to design another augmented benefits for the product to satisfy your consumer. Now taking the same example of hotel room. Okay, now what are the augmented benefits that are being provided by a hotel room? If I talk about Hilton Hotels, which is shown in the right side of the picture here. In the Hilton Hotel, when you are booking a room for yourself, this digital check-in service is provided to you, whereby as a guest, you can pick a specific room of your choice before the arrival. See, many of us, when we book the airline ticket online, they are giving you an option that do you want a window seat or an aisle seat or the middle seat. So before paying the money, you can decide for yourself which sort of seat do you want for yourself, and accordingly you can make the payment. So similar sort of facility is being provided by the Hilton Hotel also, okay, whereby you can choose a specific room of your choice before arriving into the hotel. Now this is an example of augmented benefit which is being provided by the hotels to the guest or the customers who are going to check into the hotel. Now another very interesting example came across was in Maldives. Okay, there are certain luxury resorts. These luxury resorts are called Conrad Maldives Regali Island. Now what are they doing? They are providing underwater hotel experience to the customers. So what is happening here? You get a thrilling experience of being very close to the marine life. So you can book your room whereby your room will be under the water, and additionally they also provide underwater restaurant. Now this is something as guest or as a consumer you may not have expected, and this is something beyond your expectation, which is exceeding your satisfaction towards the product. So this is what is being called as augmented level of the product. But yes, if you remember in the very beginning when I had started this topic, I said the product level model is also known as value hierarchy, because what is being happening here, at each level you are adding some values to your product, you are adding some extra benefits for the consumer to the product, and this extra value which being added to the product also increases the cost of the product or of the service, which of course the consumer has to bear. So this is the best example for augmented level of the product. Now moving ahead, final level of the product is called potential level of the product. How are you going to transform your product? Now these potential benefits from the example of the same hotel is first wireless charging system. How many of you know that there are something called charging mats? So many of these hotels nowadays are providing you with charging mat, which is shown in the first picture, wireless charging. So what is happening? All you have to do is you don't need to take your charger with you for charging your smartphones. There will be this charging mat. All you have to do is you have to put your smartphones on this charging mat, and your headphones, your smartphones will be getting charged. Now, this is potential level or potential benefit which a consumer gets out of your product or the service which you have taken. In the same way, you also have voice activated controls nowadays, which are provided by the hotels to the guests. Now, what are these voice activated controls? We all are well aware of Amazon Alexa. We keep watching all these advertisements of Alexa, whereby whatever command you give to the Alexa, it obeys. You say, Alexa, play this song for me, and it starts playing the song for you. You say, Alexa, switch off the lights for me, and the lights are switched off for you, right? So the same technology is being used nowadays by the hotels. You have these smart speakers like Amazon Alexa, which are being used with a software called Volera. It is a voice-based software, which is being used by the hardware like Alexa. So what is this Volera along with Alexa doing? As a guest, you can give voice commands to the Alexa, and using the software Volera, your voice commands will be sent to the hotel personnel. Now, this is the best example of potential benefits which are being provided to the guest by the hotels. And lastly, you have smart mirrors. Now, what are these smart mirrors? Now, this is one of the advanced technology. Talk of Marriott Hotel, talk of Hyatt Regency. Okay, the top-notch hotels are providing you with smart mirrors in the rooms. It is one of the innovative ways to improve the guest experience. It is, as you can see in the picture, it is a touch-based mirror whereby it is also voice-enabled that acts as a screen using which you can lock your room. You can open the curtains of your room. You can call for a wallet, that is male servant. You can make dinner reservation or any, you know, information that you want to get, as it's being shown in the picture. What is the weather today? What is the weather outside? What is, how is the traffic outside? All the information will be available to you on your fingertips using the smart mirror. So these smart mirrors have created a new way of communication between the hotel and the guest. And these are the examples of the potential benefits or potential level of a product. So now we have covered the topic of what are the different levels of product which were proposed in the year 1960 by the father of marketing management, Philip Kotler. Now let us have a look at what are the key takeaways from this five product level model. As we have seen, the consumers have five different level of needs for a single product. Now when I have taken the example of hotel room, I have taken the example of a single product for which I have five different level of needs, which now my needs could be based on, as I had said in yesterday's lecture, psychological needs, emotional needs, okay, economic, perceptual needs. Now, the five product level model also argues that consumers must derive value from a product that is not directly related to its functionality. Now, if you remember yesterday when I was talking about functionality, what I said, functionality means the basic function that a product forms. When I was purchasing a printer, the basic function that a printer performs is giving me the hard copies of the document or the printout of the document. But a product is not purchased only for the functionality need which is being served by a product. But in addition to this functionality need, there are other needs also which needs to be satisfied by a product. So as we have seen in the five product level model, you are deriving different values from a single product or different benefits from a single product which is being offered to you. And finally, the five product level model explains how a product may move through five levels of development. See, when I give you the example of this hotel room, what did we see? That how at each level the development is being taking place up to the level of potential development, right? Up to the level of potential benefits or the transformations which are being taking place in the product, right? So this is being told or shown by your five product level model, that how any product is moving through different levels of development according to the degree of market differentiation and subsequent consumer benefits. See, as I told you earlier, talk of any product, your product needs to have some unique features. It should be differentiated from other products or brands which are available in the market. If your product is not unique, if you have not added differentiation to your product, then why will the customer purchase your product? He can go to your competitor. So as a marketer, when you are designing the levels of the product which you are going to offer in the market, you have to think of the unique features of the differentiation that you are going to add to your product in order to have a competitive edge over your competitor, so that the customers come to you and do not go to your competitor. Differentiations or unique features are being added at each level of the product. So that was all about the 5 product level model.